Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to my channel. Feel free to subscribe. In today's Excel video, this is for Microsoft 365 users only. A brand new feature will be out soon. It came out to Microsoft 365 insiders on January 25th, 2023. Great feature. You can now preview what you have in your formula. So let me demonstrate this. I'm going to use absolute reference, but in my Excel function, I'm going to write an if statement. Then I'll come and do an if and statement just to show you how this feature works. Great feature. So here we go. I've got a bunch of reps. I've got their numbers. Just come over here and highlight and get their totals and just do an auto sum at one time. There's that. Here's their commission. I am making this up. If F7 is greater than cell B4, which is going to be absolute reference, I'm going to give them $1,000. That's a fixed amount. And then I'll come back and give them a percentage of what it is over. But if it's not over that, I'm going to put in a blank. So here's our if statement, and then we'll do an if and there are chapters down below. So equals if, is this number greater than this number? B4 needs to be absolute reference. Press the F4 function key, comma, three arguments, value of true. I want to give them, I'm making this up. I'm going to give them $1,600, comma, value of false. I want it to be a blank. So put it in quotes, control enter. We'll keep you in the same cell. There's my $1,600 auto filled down, and there are some blanks. Here you go. Click in here once. My formula bar is up above column B and C. But if I double click in here and I start mousing over stuff, notice it says logical test. Here's the new feature. When I click logical test, it says true directly above the F7 greater than B4. Value of true, when I click it, is letting me know they're going to get $1,600 for this example. And value of false, that means it's a blank. So let's tweak this one time before we do the if and. I would in real life probably not give them a set amount or a fixed amount. I would give them a certain percentage whatever they did over $8,500. So that's going to be, let's give them 20% times F7 minus B4. And again, B4 needs to be absolute reference. So I'm taking the difference of whatever they did over $8,500 and giving them 20% of that amount. Helps if you close it, close the parent. There we go. This person is going to get $790, auto-filled down with a double click. Notice the amounts are different because we're getting them a percentage over. So we'll see what happens here when I come in here now. I'm still going to get true. But here, it is actually calculating and telling me what the amount is of that part of this Excel function. Really cool feature right there. Let's just do one more person, click in here, value of true, look, 1440. So that was example one of this feature. Example two, I'm going to do an if and function for you. Very similar to what I just did, but here's what I want to know. Two requirements here. So it's still an if function, but they still have to be over in column F. They still have to be over the $8,500, which is sitting in cell B4. But they also have needed to completed training, and training needs to be set to yes for them to get an additional $800. So here's the additional bonus that they can get, equal if, and you can have 64 ands in case you're wondering. I like to work from left to right. I could start with training, but I'm going to go over here first. Same exact steps to start off with. Absolute reference, comma. Here's my second and right here. Is that cell H7 equal to yes? close. I'm done with the and this and is my logical test for the if statement. Comma, value of true. I cannot remember what I said. I'm going to do $800. Value of false. We're being generous. I'm gonna type in here, and actually, we're not being generous. I'm gonna put in here, try again next year. In real life, I wouldn't do that, but yes, done. Crosshairs, double click, and there you go. Let's go see what happens with this live preview inside the formula. Double click. Let's go look at the ands. Here we go. Logical test. I don't care about that one. It's going to say false. Value of true. Actually, I'm sorry. I want to go to the and part. Logical test one for the and. Remember, there are two ands. It's telling me that that's false, but it's also telling me the second part is false. Let's tweak this real quick. This person did complete training. Still, she could say try again next year. But when I'm reading through here and I come to logical two, instead of saying false, it says that that part's true. So it's the first part that they missed out on. There you go. I actually really love this, and I can see myself using this a lot. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe. I guess that's it. Have a good day. Thank you.